That was far too nice, Angel. I expected worse from you, so thank you. All right, let's talk a little bit about containers and what we're doing in IBM around containers. IBM believes that containers are an amazing part of the future of software development and a really key aspect of our strategy around hybrid and the way that we think all of you are going to be building and running applications in the future. There is no technology that I've seen have such an impact in such a short time like containers. What I want to talk about is a little bit about what we've been doing around containers. We have a service in IBM Bluemix called the Container Service that provides a fully managed environment for you to run container-based applications. We actually support containers in Bluemix in two forms. We have a Docker-based container service, and we have the largest public Cloud Foundry deployment in the world, which, in case you guys don't know, is a great, amazing container platform. This container capability within Bluemix has all of the capabilities and lifecycle wrapped around it that you need: logging, monitoring, load balancing, image registries, security, vulnerability, all the capabilities that you need to run real applications in a container-based environment. And we're building that technology, that service, on top of amazing communities. Now, we're at OTS, so you probably don't want to hear a lot about our product. So let's talk a little bit about actually how we built this thing and how open technologies come together to help us build amazing capabilities like the container service. One of the things that I'm so excited about is how all of these open communities are actually working together and contributing different ideas to build amazing solutions. We heard from Jonathan today about OpenStack, and Sam talked to us about Cloud Foundry, and those components play a huge role in how we actually built a container service. This is a simple picture of how our container service is built, a very, very high-level picture of how it's built. There's a few key elements in a container service. You have a pool of container hosts that host your containers and run your applications. In our service, those container hosts are running on Docker, they are multi-tenant, and they are bare metal. They are high-performance, shared container hosts. You don't have to be bothered with the complexities of running that environment. We have orchestration wrapped around those hosts, which is responsible for deploying and monitoring and managing the execution of those containers and assigning or placing those workloads across the system. We, of course, have image registries. We have an API layer. That API layer is Docker today, hopefully moving towards things like OCI and CNCF as those foundations come up to speed and start to give us, through our work together, an industry-agreed-to, community-based definition of what the API to a container world looks like. So what I want to do is dive into this a little bit and talk about some of the elements that make up the stack and the components that we're using and bringing together. Because one of the things that we're doing in IBM as part of our cloud strategy is bringing together OpenStack and Docker and Cloud Foundry and Elastic and Node and Swift into a single, coherent, powerful platform for building and running applications. So let's dive in a little bit. Where does Docker play a role? Of course, Docker is the engine that we're using to run your containers and our container services. We provide a native container experience. You're not responsible for managing container hosts. The registry that we expose, the API we expose, and even the CLI that we expose to allow you to interact with that service on Bluemix is today a Docker API, a Docker CLI, a Docker registry interface. And we are contributing and participating in that community, both as maintainers and as contributors, to help build out that technology. Now, we've done some things that we think are special. We run on bare metal. We take the overhead of a hypervisor out of the path for our public execution. And we manage with a simple interface. So Docker, of course, as you might guess, plays an important role in a container service. What about OpenStack? Well, there's some interesting things we're doing with OpenStack. Of course, we run our container service on an infrastructure. It needs compute, it needs storage, it needs a network. And we run that service on top of OpenStack. And we've done interesting integration. So for example, in our container service, we expose your containers with a full IP address, with a full network. All of your containers run on their own private network. All of your containers, if you're building a microservices application, can talk to each other on that private network, disconnected from the rest of the world. You can expose containers with a full public IP address if you want to put a container on the network. And we accomplish that by connecting the Docker container world to the neutron layer within OpenStack So we have a single consistent networking layer underneath all these technologies. What that means is as we go forward in time, we can also build applications that combine technologies in seamless ways. We could have VMs running on OpenStack and containers and Docker and applications under CF and services, all sharing the same network, all sharing the same substrate, because they're all leveraging the same control plane with things like Neutron. Well, what about Cloud Foundry? How does Cloud Foundry fit in? You know, one of the things I love about having this broader perspective is that it allows us to see how things really play out. And I think you talk to a lot of people who are completely obsessed with the container world, and their mental model of the world is that everything is going to be a container. I'm just going to run the whole world in a bunch of containers. Well, that's not reality. The reality is you're going to have a more heterogeneous environment. One of the things that I think Cloud Foundry did exceptionally well is come up with a model for services. That a lot of the things we consume are actually going to be services on the cloud, APIs that we need to connect to, provision, bind to. They invented a model within Cloud Foundry to surface those things as a catalog, to provision them easily, to bind to them, to unbind from them. And so what we've done in our container services, we've taken that exact model and we've integrated in with a Docker container world. So whether you're running a Cloud Foundry app or you're running a container-based app on Docker, in Bluemix, you can take the same catalog of 100 plus services that we've exposed through service brokers, and you can bind them to any kind of application you choose to use in the construction of your app. So we've brought those two worlds together. We've also done things like bring the routing layer together. Cloud Foundry has a powerful external routing layer with GoRouter that allows you to very simply connect an HTTP endpoint into your application. And we've taken that same layer within Cloud Foundry and we've connected it into containers. So we've brought those two worlds together and we've allowed a single consistent solution. Right? I'd love to see that happen more formally in places like the Cloud Foundry Foundation and CNCF as we bring those ideas together. Final thing is Elastic. What good is it running applications in the cloud if you don't have visibility into what's going on with those applications? If you can't see logs and metrics and get an idea if it's performing well or if it's having a problem? And why is it that you should have to be responsible for figuring out how to connect, wire to, or stand up the infrastructure necessary for you to get that visibility? And so what we've done in Bluemix is we have a shared logging service based on Elastic, and we automatically connect your containers into that service. So as a developer, you run a container-based application on Bluemix, all of your logs, all of your metrics, automatically without you modifying your images, without installing agents or forwarders, all that data gets captured from those applications, fed into this common logging service, which is based on Elasticsearch and Kibana, and allows you to get that visibility in to what's going on in your applications. And we can take that same exact environment and we're wiring it into things like Cloud Foundry apps and we're wiring it into VMs. So if you have a heterogeneous application, you can get a single view of what's going on across your applications. So I think the power of this community that we're building together, the power of this technology and working on it together is how we can bring it in, bring it together, connect it together, and allow the strengths of all of this amazing innovation to be linked in a way that allows us to move faster together and build amazing applications. Thank you.
Thanks, Jason. Thank you.